What's up, everybody? My name is Prestige, and thank you all so much for joining me on the channel. Today, we're going to be taking our very first look at the Ascendance DLC in the form of a trailer, which I was really surprised that came out because I thought the trailer was going to be coming out during the Call of Duty Championship, but instead, what they're going to be doing at the championships is they're going to be showing us the entirety of the Infection cutscene, which I'm actually really excited for, and they're going to have a live demonstration of some of these maps, so it's going to be really interesting. I'm excited to see what's going to happen there, and I actually am going to the Call of Duty Championship, so if you guys want me to record some footage of that or anything, let me know down below in the comments section. But let us get started, because this is a pretty awesome trailer with a lot of cool things, and I'm going to actually go through it with you guys, something that I've never done before. We're going to pause it and cut it through, and the very first thing that I see here on the map Perplex is this kind of intro panning into the map. For some strange reason, this right here reminds me of the back of the ship on Hijacked for Black Ops 2. I don't know why, it just reminds me of the layout like 100% for some reason. Even though you could jump up on those little apartment complexes and you got those little drones flying in new pieces of the building, it just reminds me of Hijacked, and that's not a bad thing at all. So moving forward, you can see that this is going to be a pretty vertical map. Not only a good thing for some machine gun users, assault rifle users, and snipers, it's constantly changing, which makes me wonder what they're going to be doing with domination. If they take the A and C objective and put them on moving platforms, that would be awesome. So this map overall is just going to be an interesting one. There's nothing really too much to talk about here except for the layout and how great it's going to be for objective modes. But let's go ahead and move on to the next map, which is climate. And we can see that there's a lot going on here. It looks like a very tropical area inside of a biodome. It almost looks kind of surreal, to be honest. Like, this is the last hope for humanity or something. We got some weird rock formations. It's almost like a resort, which is actually really, really cool. And it would seem like there's a lot of different paths you could take: underground, above ground, through buildings, things of that nature. So it's going to be great for assault rifles, submachine guns. I don't know if this is going to be in particular a good map for snipers, because it just doesn't seem like that type of map. And then finally, we could see that there's a Goliath just being completely, I don't know if it's being electrocuted or what from this water. I don't know if it's an issue going on there, but that's exactly what's happening, and it looks crazy. So moving on to Chop Shop, we can clearly see that this is taking place in a really bad part of town. And from the looks of it, this brand new like sentry gun, I don't know if it's going to be an attachment for the sentry gun or if this is the map-based core streak, because this thing is just tearing people apart. It reminds me of a Guardian from Black Ops 2, and that's, once again, not a bad thing at all. It looks really, really cool. So this is most likely going to be the in-game score streak that's available for that map. And then finally, we have Site 244. Site 244 takes place in Mount Rushmore. There's an alien ship that crash landed down. And speaking of aliens, from this orbital care package, we get something called the Super Serum. The Super Serum is activated by just like slapping this bag. I don't know if it goes onto your chest or what, but it just completely turns your character into a tunnel vision green person. And just looking at what is going on, you can see that all of the enemies in front of this person are lighting up almost as if they've been tagged by a recon drone. However, I don't think that that's the case for this. I think that this super serum will actually let you have that type of vision, as well as other abilities like the Blessing of Anubis from Call of Duty Ghosts, if you guys remember that streak. I think it's also going to increase your speed and most likely your health, but I'm not sure how long it's going to last for. It could be one life, it could be two lives, it could be three lives. I have no idea at this point, but all I know is it looks badass, and I cannot wait to see just exactly what this does. Moving forward to the bonus weapon, we can just see some gameplay of the bonus weapon. It's out right now for season pass holders on the Xbox One and Xbox 360. And then finally, we get our very first look at the grapple mode, which I gotta say is pretty badass. I mean, just looking at it from this very first frame, going from one spot to another. And also, one other thing that you can see in this is it actually recharges. So you can use the grappling hook two times, and then it needs to recharge, but I think that that's really cool. And then we can just see some more showing off with the grappling hook, basically hooking onto anything. And then right here at the end, you can see our soldier just grappling hooking an enemy and killing them in one hit. And I'm going to make it my goal inside of this map pack to try to use that grappling hook and just kill as many people as I possibly can. Another thing that's going to be coming with that is a grapple hook playlist. So it's going to be I think specific to that playlist, most likely, and specific to the Ascendance DLC. You're not going to be able to use it in other maps like Detroit and Solar. That's just not going to be available there. So if you get Ascendance, you'll be able to use the grappling hook and play in the grapple hook playlist. I'm sorry. And I think it's going to be really, really cool. So I'm excited to try to kill some people with it. And finally, moving on to Infection, we get some different frames and some different looks at zombies. So we got our Burger Town. We got a drive-through going on. I don't know if there's anything to do with that drive-through. I'm not going to do a major breakdown for zombies right now. I think I'm going to save it for another video. But we got our cutscene playing out. They're on the roof of the Burger Town. They're really focusing on this Burger Town. Like, it's going to be the main focal point of this map. But out of everything that's here on this map, I'm not sure if I would want this to be the main focal point. It just kind of looks like that's going to be the case. We also get our very first look at what I expect to be the microwave weapon, which looks really cool. If you look closely at one scene, you can see that the enemy, or the zombie rather, is kind of blowing up. Right here, you can see that it's just kind of expanding and it looks really cool. So I'm not sure if it's going to be a quicker kill or what, but I think that that is pretty badass nonetheless. And then finally, with our final scene, you can see that there is somebody being rescued onto this warbird, and I imagine that it's part of the new mode where you can actually rescue survivors. So I think that that's what that is from. It might be part of the Easter egg, it might not, I'm not sure. We'll have to wait and find out. And I don't know if you guys caught this part right here, but they're running through the sewer, and if you look closely, there is an alligator that jumps up out of the water and clamps onto the zombie. It is badass. But anyway, let me know what you guys think down below in the comments section. Let me know if you're excited for the Ascendance DLC. It's coming out on March 31st for Xbox users and somewhere down the line for PlayStation users, probably a month later or whatever the agreement is. But if you enjoyed this video, make sure to click that like button down below and do not forget to subscribe for more awesome videos each and every day. Until next time, everybody, I am out. Peace!